Good morning. Welcome to St. George's on this Sunday of Remembrance. A particular word of welcome to any who are visiting or who are new this morning, and a word of gratitude and welcome to our many guest musicians who are helping to lift up our prayer and praise and remembrance this morning. Everything that you need to be part of today's service can be found in the service bulletin that you would have received when you came in. And our opening hymn is number 576, For the Healing of the Nations.
Grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
Thank you. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Almighty God, as you gather your people together in hallowed remembrance, we give you thanks for all who have laid down their lives for our sake, and whom you have gathered from the storm of war into the peace of your presence. Let the memory of their devotion ever be an example to us, that we at the last, being faithful unto death, may receive with them the crown of life, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Jesus Christ, according to Mark.
Glory to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
As Jesus taught, he said, "Beware of the scribes who like to walk around in long robes and to be greeted with respect in the marketplaces and to have the best seats in the synagogues and places of honor at banquets. They devour widows' houses, and for the sake of appearance, say long prayers. They will receive the greater condemnation." He sat down opposite the treasury and watched the crowd putting money into the treasury. Many rich people put in large sums. A poor widow came and put in two small copper coins, which are worth a penny. Then he called his disciples and said to them, "Truly, I tell you, this poor widow has put in more than all those who are contributing to the treasury. For all of them have contributed out of their abundance, but she, out of her poverty, has put in everything she had, all she had to live on." The Gospel of Christ.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Thank you.
In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. In our multicultural world, the experience that I am going to name is by no means an unusual or unique experience. In my life, I have had the opportunity to serve with, minister to, and befriend people who lived through World War II, not just on this side of the conflict, but on both sides of the conflict. That dialogue and reflection that we have been able to do across lines that used to be war lines allows us a deeper understanding of that darkness and that evil and those powers of destruction that tried to lay claim to human life during those years of World War II. I think of family friends that we had in Germany who talked about the end of World War II not as a time when Germany lost the war, but a time when Germany was set free from the rule of the Nazis. Millions of lives lost in combat. Millions of innocent civilian lives lost in the crossfires of war. Millions of people rounded up and exterminated in cold blood because of who and what they were. Years of incredible darkness, which makes it all the more remarkable that there was a whole generation of men and women, many of whom were very young, who saw the loss of certainty, the loss of stability, the loss of the world as they knew it, and who chose not to be powerless in the face of that loss. A whole generation of men and women who came to see that their lives were not just for themselves, it wasn't just about self-preservation, that they could become offering. They could become sacrifice in the pursuit of the highest of ideals, the building of a world of freedom and peace for us all. That same contrast between loss and offering is very much present in our gospel story today. Through the eyes of Jesus, we meet a nameless widow. And we can understand that in Jesus' day, widows were considered to be a group that was most vulnerable in that society because this woman is impoverished. We know that when her husband died, she lost everything. All stability, all certainty, all status. She did not have other family members to care for her. She is seen as nothing. She is invisible. But Jesus sees her. And Jesus lifts her up for us to see as well. Two insignificant copper coins worth only a penny. And yet he names her offering as the most generous and the most faithful. Everything that she has is taken from her, and yet she chooses to give everything. We know that those forces of evil and darkness are still loose in our world today. Maybe we are particularly aware as we have been led to see the destruction currently going on in Syria, for example. Millions of people similarly dead or displaced because of an accident of race or creed or circumstance. But we don't have to live in Syria to see how those forces of destruction seek to claim human life across countries, across communities, across families, even within individuals. And yet, that better world that that generation fought for, that better world is also here. We here, right now, enjoy a freedom and a peace and a prosperity that most people in most parts of the world through most of history have never had. As citizens of this country, we are called at this time of year to remembrance and thanksgiving. But as people of the gospel, we are called one step further. We are called to be implicated by our blessings and by our gratitude and by our remembrance. What are we doing with our hard-won freedom and peace and prosperity? Are we like those leaders in Jesus' example who do not see what we have and do not see the suffering in front of us? Have we been led to believe that our freedom is just about individualism? I can choose a better cell phone plan and a healthier breakfast cereal for myself. Or can I dare to imagine, can we dare to imagine that our lives can also become offering? Offering for God's dream. That freedom and peace is not just for me and not just for us, but for all of us. May the beauty of this Requiem music this morning lift up our prayers for peace, our acts of remembrance. May we be led again to gather around God's table and receive God's good gifts. And may our lives be shaped into lives of offering, so that in partnership with God, the better world that has been built for us can be built for all of us. Amen.
At this time, I would like to invite all of those who have served with the Canadian military, both reserve and regular forces, to please stand. Let us pray. Almighty God, you are our refuge and our strength. We humble ourselves in your presence, and remembering the great things you have done for us, we lift up our hearts in adoration and praise. As you have gathered us together, we give you thanks for all who served this country in time of trial. In remembrance of those who made the supreme sacrifice, make us better men and women, and give us peace in our time, O Lord. Amen.
In remembrance of those members of the parish of St. George's and also of the parish of St. Barnabas who paid the supreme sacrifice, 1914 to 1918. Robert Andrew J. Allen, William Bean, Charles Alfred Body, Herbert Burns, Arthur Gervais Daft, Archie Harold Dale, T.J. Evans, James Harold Ingersoll, Mortimer Arnold Nealon, Norman Patterson, John Perkins, Albert Rothwell, Donald Swindley, B.C. White, F.S. Witten, Samuel DeVoe Woodruff. 1939 to 1945, John Allen, Lesley Ashburner, Roger A.C. Ashford, Ernest A.W. Byrd, Earl G. Blong, Peter H. Byrne, Robert C. Butler, James O. Cobley, William R. Cookson, John E. Coombs, John A. Dory, William H. E. Drury, Dennis Everest, Ralph H. Frost, Alan Halsey, William D. W. Hilton, John W. Hollinshead, Leonard L. Holmes, Noel T. Kister, Donald S. McGregor, John D. Neal, Arthur T. Orrell, John H. Oliver, Robert Peary, Richard R. Schmoen, Kenneth L. Schonk, George Raymond Spencer, Raymond Watson, Frank R. Windebank. 2009, Afghanistan, Dennis R. Brown. They grow not old as we that are left grow old. Age shall not weary them, nor the years condemn. At the going down of the sun and in the morning, we will remember them. Lord God of hosts, be with us yet, lest we forget. Please remain standing.
Gracious God, your word to us is food indeed. Receive all we offer you this day, and let your loving kindness be our comfort. For the sake of Jesus Christ, your living word. Amen. We have been praying for those who gave their lives in service to this country. We pray also for two people from this congregation who died this week, for Stan Cavan and for Jean Magnell, and we remember their families as we gather together at this Eucharist this morning. We also bring before God those who've asked for our prayers amongst the living, and those whom we've brought to this service, particularly in our hearts this morning. And so we remember Sandra, Jennifer, Joan, Susan, Reed, Bart, Carla, Tara, Andrew, Carolyn, Gwen, Taylor, Ruth, Bruce, Ted, Paulina, John, Emily, Brianna, and Kyle. And we offer all of those people to God's blessing as we gather in this Eucharist this morning. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Thank you. Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. We give you thanks and praise, Almighty God, through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, our Savior and Redeemer. He is your living Word, through whom you have created all things. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he took flesh of the Virgin Mary and shared our human nature. He lived and died as one of us to reconcile us to you, the God and Father of all. In fulfillment of your will, he stretched out his hands in suffering to bring release to those who place their hope in you, and so he won for you a holy people. He chose to bear our griefs and sorrows and to give up his life on the cross, that he might shatter the chains of evil and death and banish the darkness of sin and despair. By his resurrection, he brings us into the light of your presence. Now, with all creation, we raise our voices to proclaim the glory of your name.
Thank you.
Holy and gracious God, accept our praise through your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, who on the night he was handed over to suffering and death, took bread and gave you thanks, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body, which is given for you." In the same way, he took the cup, saying, "This is my blood, which is shed for you. When you do this, you do it in memory of me." Remembering, therefore, his death and resurrection, we offer you this bread and this cup, giving thanks that you have made us worthy to stand in your presence and serve you. We ask you to send your Holy Spirit upon the offering of your holy church. Gather into one all who share in these sacred mysteries, filling them with the Holy Spirit and confirming their faith in the truth, that together we may praise you and give you glory through your servant, Jesus Christ. All glory and honor are yours, Father and Son, with the Holy Spirit in the Holy Church, now and forever. Amen. And now, as our Savior has taught us, let us pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Christ, our Passover, is sacrificed for us. Therefore, let us keep the feast. Behold the Lamb of God who takes away the sin of the world. Jim, I usually turn the lights on now. She's sticking out. She's helping.
Thank you. these two haven't had the blood yet. They've kind of got the body of Christ broken for you. The body of Christ broken for you. Yeah. The body of Christ broken for you. Reach out, the body of Christ broken for you.
Yeah.
Let us pray. Living God, in this Eucharist, you fill us with new hope. May the power of your love, which we have known in word and sacrament, continue your saving work among us and bring us to the joy you promise. We ask this in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Amen.
Running out.
In keeping with the beauty and solemnity of our worship today, I want to keep my announcements to a minimum and trust you to read most of them in the Saints Connection today. I want to say on behalf of all of us, thank you to all of our musicians today, our choir, our guest musicians, and John Butler for his leadership in putting together today's Requiem Mass. Thank you so much. I think that it is so fitting that I get to share with you today the news that our associate priest, Reverend Scott McLeod, has been awarded this year the YMCA Peace Medallion for his work in refugee sponsorship. Congratulations, Scott. I think that you offer incredible leadership in showing us all how we can work for that better world. Following the service, we will have a time of refreshment and fellowship in the Asbel Lounge through this door, down a long, winding hallway. It's not in the Asbel Lounge? Oh, okay. It's in the downstairs. It's still out this door, down a winding hallway and then down some stairs. And if you don't know how to get to that time of fellowship, ask somebody who looks like they know what they're doing. Our final hymn this morning is number 528.
Love and serve the Lord.
Thanks.